No, I can't end this way. It has to be here. Time since I last vlogged, but for good reason. I guess I should get you caught up. Where to begin, really? Up until a year ago, I was going to school here in New York State, working on my MFA, which is pretty much the toughest art program imaginable. It didn't go what you would call well. I flunked out, but I had made Ithaca my home, and there was no way I was going back to sultry San Diego to live with my mother and her third and richest husband, Chip. So I emptied my already severely depleted trust fund and paid an entire year's rent on an apartment I couldn't have otherwise afforded. I had a plan, a brilliant, albeit not terribly well thought out plan. I wouldn't have to I wouldn't have to worry about school or work or my stepfather's inevitable IRS investigations. I would just paint. That was all I wanted to do. And for a while, that was enough. This was last year. The painting hasn't exactly been the grandiose endeavor that I had imagined. Fun, but not much more than that, really. No grand artistic breakthroughs to boast about here on Avenue Avery. To further complicate things, the savings off of which I've managed to live for the past 12 months is running out just in time to perfectly coincide with the end of my lease. So, to recap, I'm completely broke. I have no job, no prospects for a job. I have no dedication to the art of being a graduate student, and the art to which I'm apparently dedicated, I'm obviously not that good at. So, there you have it. There's my that doesn't make any sense. There you have it. That's my ultra interesting life that I haven't vlogged about for months. Isn't it just delightful? P.S. No, mother, I'm not moving back home, so you can just forget it. Oh, and I love you.
It's empty in the valley of your heart. The sun, it rises slowly as you walk away from all the fears and all the faults you've left behind. The harvest left no food for you to eat. You cannibal, you meat eater, you see. But I have seen the same. I know the shame in your defeat. But hold on hope, and I won't let you choke on the noose around your neck, and I'll find strength in pain, and I will change my ways. I'll know my name as it's called again.
Oh my god.
Ow.
I'm so sorry. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
I didn't even see you there.
I assumed.
Here, let me help you up.
What's in that thing? Bricks?
Close. Books. Lots and lots of books.
Okay, wait, are you moving in next door?
Yeah, that's me.
Wow, I didn't think anyone would rent that little apartment. It's tiny.
That it is.
There aren't any windows.
Skylights. That's cool.
Yeah, we'll see how cool it is when it's pouring rain and you can't sleep. You wish there was a layer of puppies over it.
Well, there's something to look forward to. I'm Dan. Dan Williams.
Avery Ross.
It was nice running into you.
Oh, I get it because you knocked me over. That was good.
Thanks.
And who knows, maybe in a couple weeks you can move into my place.
You going somewhere?
You mean right now, in 2 weeks, or in life generally?
I'm not even sure.
Yeah, well, all three are long stories. Welcome to the building, Dan.
Thanks.
Y-
Yeah, he's cute, so?
So? A cute guy moving in next door to you is big news. News that you must share with your best friend.
I'm sorry, Natalie, what happened to Brian?
Brian's a jerk.
A jerk you've been sleeping with for a month?
Well, he's a very good-looking jerk, what can I say?
And, okay, what about Brian, the other one, with the Y?
Haven't spoken to him in months. More accurately, he hasn't spoken to me in months. Me being the reason we broke up.
Don't you actually have to be dating to break up?
Yeah, that's why there were air quotes. Should you really be shopping right now?
It's Salvation Army. I could go nuts in here and not spend $20.
Right. So, back to Dan.
Really?
What? You piqued my interest.
I'm sure he's a great guy and all, but I don't really care right now. Besides, I'm probably not going to be here much longer.
You'll be fine. We'll find you a job and all will be well.
Yeah, with my highly desirable skill set, I'm exactly what the job market's looking for.
I'm not saying it won't be a challenge. I can see if the magazine's hiring.
I suck at writing.
Yeah, that's true. And it's an online magazine at that, so you're really out of your league there.
Well, I do vlog, you know.
Yes. You record yourself on a cheap webcam, whereas I write for an online magazine, which I get paid. You want to argue who's better with the internet?
Point taken. So, Steven called last night.
I'm sorry. In my field, we call that burying the lead. Steven called?
Yeah.
What did he want?
I don't know. We just talked.
About?
I don't know.
Please, you can still recite every text message he sent you from 3 years ago.
I don't know.
Come on. Did you tell him?
Tell him what?
That you're still into him.
Duh, after we talked about our favorite breakfast cereal, but before we hit on the political situation in Pakistan, I was like, Steven, by the way, I am eerily and obsessively still in love with you, despite the fact we only dated for 1 month, 3 years ago, and have been nothing but friends ever since. Long distance friends at that, since you go away to school in Texas every year. That's exactly what I said, Natalie. What kind of psycho non-girlfriend girlfriend do you take me for?
Gee, don't crash that sarcasm plane now.
God, why can't I get over him?
Beats me.
Thanks, Nat. Oh my god.
What?
A frickin' iPod at Salvo? Score.
Ooh, what kind?
I don't know, it's old.
There's no way that thing still works.
I don't care, I'm depressed and broke, so I'm taking it.
Everything's gonna be fine, Eve.
I don't know, Avery, I'm booked solid right now.
I know you said last month there wasn't any space, but I was thinking maybe if someone had to back out or something.
Sorry, Ave, I just can't do it right now.
Just, I'll take whatever you have, anything. I will show in the closet, in the bathroom, in a bathroom closet, anything.
I don't know what to tell you. Maybe next month.
Good morning.
Hi,
hey.
I was wondering if you were hiring?
Rise, the mountain always takes me by surprise. I didn't know what snow looked like. I didn't realize it would be so silent. And so it goes, you've broken another bone, but you'll be cared for by the girl you're dreaming of. I bet you're wishing for another fracture.
My BMI have to do is selling clothes. Really? God
Avery,
damn it!
Jesus Christ!
One of us needs to wear a belt.
You okay?
Yeah, perfect. I'm sitting on this disgusting floor for the second time today. My butt hurts. Just spent the entire day getting turned down for menial grunt work. We have a single painting that's worth a damn. I can't pay my rent. I can't go home. And for the life of me, I can't stop thinking about... Never mind. Sorry. Just a little mental breakdown.
It's okay. Is that why you're leaving? No job?
No job, no money, no nothing. Quite a nice life I built, huh?
Can't be all bad, can it?
No, actually, at one point it was pretty great. I was happy. And then it all went to shit.
That sucks.
Yeah.
Listen, I'm going out for a drink with some friends. Do you want to come? Maybe get your mind off of everything? I'm buying.
I'm really not feeling it tonight, you know?
I understand.
Maybe next time, if I'm still in the same time zone, that is.
Right.
Good night, Dan.
Good night.
December 23rd? Oh no.
Yeah, no, we called him Windex because he would sit on the, he would literally sit on the windowsill and smash his head against the glass like that.
That is the most horrible and the most cutest thing I've ever heard.
I've told you that one before.
No, you didn't.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I did.
That's definitely something I think I would remember.
Maybe,
Is it 7 o'clock already?
Yeah.
I'll be back in a sec. I just have to use the bathroom.
Is that a standing 7 o'clock appointment?
Very funny. Shit. Avery, look out for the thing. Sorry. Here. Listen, you have to watch that with Dan, okay? He'll be able to explain. Take the envelope, touch the numbers, and it'll take you back to where you started from. Everything else you need to know is in the envelope. Don't come out. Just take it and get the hell out of here. Trust me. Go back, find Dan, and open the envelope.
What the fuck just happened?